Hello, I've been making slow but steady progress. The problem is the GUI. My GUI skills are pretty poor, and they always have been. I made this GUI and it didn't look right, so I made this GUI and it works in a completely different manner, and I'm going to transition this style over to this style. Takes a while to do this sort of stupid crap. So here you can see we've got a base layer called skin, and you can edit the various parameters here. We're going to go ahead and make a beefy guy skin just as an example. There we are. And we'll go ahead and say that it's intended for men because it's a beefy guy skin. Now we could make it a different layer of clothing, but we're talking about skins. We're going to switch over into mesh edit mode, and we're just going to beef up the character in general. We're just going to do it real quick. We're not going to take a whole lot of time on it. Boom, boom. Give him some beefy legs. There we are. Something like that, right? So if we go back over into the info mode, you can see that it's intended for a male character. So if we drag this off to the left, it will get added to our inventory like that. And it creates a new layer because you always have to have at least one. But up here in the inventory, if we change what we're looking for, we can see that if we switch over to looking at entirely one gender or the other, then it vanishes. But we can add it back to the character just with a click. And it works fine. Now we can change this one. Let's go ahead and create a female figure. Go into mesh mode and just real quick block it out just as an example. There we are. How exciting. And then we go ahead and I'm going to switch it over into info mode again. Just there we are. So you can see it doesn't show up here, but if we go into both, we can see it. They both are there, and there's no limit, so we can put both onto the character. And now the same thing applies if we would like to create, say, a shirt. We'll say that it's a shirt layer, and we'll go ahead and move into mesh painting with cotton, change the color, and just paint ourselves a basic shirt. And now all the stuff that did work still works, so we can go ahead and switch over into it works except for it's hidden behind here. This is where it starts to conflict. The old and the new are kind of overlapping, but we can go ahead and turn it into wrinkle paint mode and just quickly change the brush size and put down some basic wrinkles. And I'm moving real fast here, too fast for it to keep up. You can see that the wrinkles are dots instead of wrinkles, but that's what happens when you move too fast. And we can always go ahead and add in a hem and maybe a little bit of design work. We can also change out of this cotton into a different cotton or even to a metal, and then go into brush mode and just put in some completely different materials in this shirt. Now I'm going real fast here, so obviously you would want to take your time and connect the dots correctly and all that stuff, but I'm just kind of working quick. Now it's very easy for us to save that. I'm actually going to hit view because it does look a little bit different once you've actually saved it. All right, so now we can go ahead and create another layer, which we'll just call Shirt 2, and we will make that one the same kind of thing with cotton. We'll make it green there, and then we'll just make it like a vest of some kind. The normals are a little bit damaged. I'll need to try and figure out why that is. All right, so if we go like this, and that looks kind of like a feminine shirt. So let's go over into the layer edit info and change it to a female shirt. Now if we hit view, you'll be able to see that the undershirt's pattern does in fact push through because it's just a thin cotton. So we can actually go ahead and drag that like this, and if we hit view, we'll be able to see that the vest, which is underneath, is now visible through in the same kind of pattern. And of course, we can store them. The bump mapping is all the, because of the way the bump mapping works, that I am not recalculating it. But we can see here that under clothes we have a shirt, but we don't have a shirt 2. And that's because I accidentally set it under skins. So let's go ahead and add that back in, change it to a shirt, or maybe even just an undershirt, and then drag it back over. And now we can see that it's there. And we don't have any skins or outerwear because all that stuff is over here. So if we drag this over, you can see it gets added in. And this is a simple kind of inventory management, and it's got a lot of work left to do, but you can see how it very quickly and very easily allows you to do whatever you need to do. And of course, you can still do all the bone editing stuff that you could do before. And then when you add the shirt back over, oh, click, not drag, it works fine. So you can play with it however you'd like, and you can create yourself a character that looks like you want your character to look like. That's it. Oh yeah, next step, saving and loading from the database, which I have worked out, but I'm considering making it zip up all of the data, because otherwise it just sends up raw bitmaps, and that could get pretty pricey if people start to actually use it. Anyhow, that's it.